I'm Dr. Krishna Kumar. I'm a pediatric cardiologist and I've been associated with Amrita Institute for the last 20 years, since it was started in 1998. My colleagues are Dr. Brijesh, who is a pediatric heart surgeon, and he has been specializing in operating on these very small babies, and he will talk to you about his experiences and his challenges. Dr. Mahesh is also my colleague, who is an innovator, and he will talk to you about the innovations specifically related to 3D printing and other advanced technologies that have started to make a difference in pediatric heart care. So this is the essence of the team members who are present. We also have two patient participants. Hari Krishna, he's here, and he's going to present a unique patient's perspective. And the father of one of the children who's operated will be joining us very shortly. He's having his lunch, and he also will be presenting a patient perspective. So the next hour or so, we will share our perspectives and we will take questions from you all in connection with what we have spoken. So with these few words, can I begin my presentation, or how do you suggest we go about it? We can start the presentation. Okay. I have a presentation, and the way it is going to happen today is that I will present an overview of the challenges of taking care of children with heart problems, particularly from an Indian perspective. After I have presented the challenges, my colleague, Dr. Brijesh, will talk about operating on these very small, tiny babies, what are the challenges and what can be expected. At that time, we will have a parent perspective. One of the parents of the children, premature babies that have been operated, will present his experience. That will be followed by Dr. Mahesh, who will talk about new and exciting technology. So with this, I'm going to make a beginning and tell you about challenges of pediatric heart care in India. So the whole notion of taking care of children with heart disease in India, he's going to talk to you about the challenges about operating on premature babies.
More demanding, requiring much more attention, and hence the results also differ. So as the center matures from doing surgeries in bigger children, you graduate to doing surgery in newborns. So there are only a very few centers in the country which do surgeries in newborns. The next giant step which is being done in outside the country is doing surgery in preterm children. When you enter the realm of preterm surgery, what you see are children which are less than 2 kilo. They are 1 kilo, less than 1 kilo, much more having other lesions, and hence the surgery in them is much more complex. So previously, when you have a child who is born preterm with complex congenital heart disease, they are often ignored. It's because of you need an expert care, they need much more attention, they have other problems, and the cost factor is much more. So, but recently, these are the areas where people are looking into. I'll be telling regarding the story of a child, baby of Selva Jyoti, who was born preterm in Tamil Nadu. Child was born at 30 weeks of life. Had a birth weight of 1.2, and when the child reached our hospital on admission, its weight was around 1 kg. The child was transported on ambulance to our center after an 8-hour arduous journey. When the child reached here, the child was 1 kilo and was immediately shifted to NICU and required care as any child with preterm would require. The semi-jolly on evaluation, we found that in addition to the preterm status, child had a complex heart disease. As you can see that, this is the heart of the child. The child, as you can see, the heart has four chambers, upper two chamber and the lower chamber. The child had a big defect in the lower chamber. We call it as a ventricular septal defect. This is easily the only treatment available for such a heart defect is surgery. It's not amenable to medical treatment. And it's a fairly straightforward surgery when the child is bigger. We get good results with that. But here you are having a preterm child who is having 1 kilo, then the challenges are enormous. The surgical challenge mainly, as you know, that the surgery has to be done with a small incision in the upper chambers. You don't open the lower chambers because those are the pumping chambers. So you open the upper chamber with as small an incision to avoid any long-term injury to the heart. Through that small incision, you have to go and close this port with a patch. So as the child becomes smaller and smaller, the challenges increase because the available space is less, the tissues are extremely friable, and hence the surgical challenge is much, much more when you are doing in a preterm child. The child underwent, we had to initially evaluate the child for a period of time, and once the child was reasonably stable, we had to take up the child. At the time of surgery was around 1.2 kilo. The child underwent a surgery which required a multiple of people, the intensivist, the anesthetist, surgeons, as well as the cardiologist, whole team was involved. The child underwent an operation where we closed the heart with the patch. You can see that through a small patch, the hole is closed off and the surgery is completed. As previously shown, this requires not only a pure surgery, you need a big circuit to stop the heart, to maintain the circulation and then close the defect. And present when the child came for review, child has gained significant weight and is doing well. I think we should now hear from the parents about their experience. Wow.
As we just discussed, this baby came from Tirunelveli all the way to Kochi. So at Amrita, we get patients who are referred from different parts of southern India, sometimes even from further away. But with a major problem during transport, mostly there is nobody to monitor babies, right? Sometimes ambulance or limited medical personnel, maybe expert doctor or nurse is not available. You are shifting from Tirunelveli or from Madurai or from Kanyakumari to Amrita or to any other institution. There is very little monitoring on the way. Sometimes in a baby then it's a major problem. Because by the time baby will reach the hospital, and the time will tell the complications were baby cold, blood sugar levels or this is a major problem in our country because we don't have good transportation systems. Okay, so wherever we send our babies, it is very important that we need to improve our transport systems. So we are trying to do that by introducing something like a new concept. Right now what happens is one doctor will call, say we are sending baby, and we say okay, you send, and then baby is put in ambulance and goes. Then what is happening on the way, we are not knowing because everybody gets just disconnected. So what we are trying to do is bring back all of them together. You know Uber? Have you used Uber in Chennai? So Uber, Ola, in the Madri apps, other you can call for your taxi and you can see where taxi has reached. You can contact your driver. Adhe Madri, newborn baby transport QA, we have designed one app. So that app we put in an international competition, a world competition, and one major funding agency called Grand Challenges Canada, it has given us $1 lakh Canadian dollar award for that. So now we are in the process of building this app. We will be able to see where exactly the baby has reached, what is the condition of the baby, what is the heart rate of the baby, respiration, temperature, blood pressure, adhellam monitoring team real time will communicate panna mudiyum, and both sending and receiving teams, we will be able to see on our phone. there may be a suggestion what is the condition. If there is any problem, we can immediately advise. So this is what we call as Neoport, and so this is one of the innovations that we come up because we need to keep improving to improve the life of our children. So whatever are the problems, we need to identify and keep tackling. So that is one of the things that we must do. So this is one thing I just wanted to share with you. Before sharing one more big innovation, science is developing, daily science is developing, newer inventions, newer machines, things are coming. Have you heard of 3D printing technology, anybody? Has anybody heard of 3D printing? So 3D printing, it's a new technology. What it can do is, computer would like any 3D object, 3D image, normally in the computer but the same thing we can convert into a physical object. It can be anything. For example, if people are making 3D prints from different kind of designs they are doing on the computer, and they can actually convert it into physical object. How that they do, I will tell you. But people do for many things. So now, aeroplane parts, spaceship parts, car parts, etc. They design on computer, then using technology, they convert it into actual physical object. Now, how can we use that in medicine is a major thing. So earlier, these machines which used to be very big machines, very expensive machines. Now we have small machines which can be put on the table just like this laptop. And you can use this to print out objects, to convert any 3D image into an actual physical object. For example, look at this. This is a small desktop printer. This is only this big on the table. And see how it is printing? So it's got a head. And it's got some material which is going through, and a material inject panni, or layer print panni. The head moves up, prints the next layer, moves up, prints the next layer, and the madri, the whole 3D object begins to form. This is a very, very latest.
Are you also working on 3D printing of implants?
Yes. Yes, that's the very natural next step. There are of course several guidelines and regulatory issues to be sorted out before we implant something, because a lot of quality control steps are there. But it's a technology which is very naturally going to lead to patient-specific implants. Because you can actually design any implant customized to the patient, be it a joint or be it a patch to be put inside the heart, you can completely precisely plan and print it out. So what is remaining is approval of the different kind of materials that we can use to safely print an implant.
Thank you.
So transport is a very heterogeneous structure. You look at one city, you look at one state, your district or the country, it's very heterogeneous. There are some states or some institutions which have excellent institutional ambulances or state-run ambulances. Like Amrita itself has very well-equipped ambulances. But transport always doesn't happen in that kind of a structured manner, because there are many places where the infrastructure is very, very little. And it's really difficult to find people who are trained or equipped to really transport babies, especially when you talk about newborns. Newborn handling is very difficult. And sometimes it's very basic monitoring, that's all that's required, like a temperature, like a blood sugar. But the people who are doing it are not aware when to do it, how to do it, and then the disconnect between the sender and the receiver and the transporter. So what we are trying to do is we are introducing checklists at each point so that the communication becomes clear. The moment somebody is trying to send the baby to us, there is an immediate checklist that gives us the most vital information that we need to know. And the transporter will also have a checklist which the sender and receiver will be able to dictate. So we will be able to dictate how frequently the transporter is supposed to report what parameter. And then being able to monitor it in real time, and this is an app which can be applied globally in any environment. Irrespective of whether or not you have a fully equipped ambulance or not, whether you have the detailed infrastructure or not, but this app, pretty much like the way the Uber app is being used, it can be applied across any environment, and with a very little basic training, I think that we will be able to monitor and ensure safer newborn transport using the app. Even we know, there is a centralized ambulance service, but in transit monitoring is absolutely suboptimal. And that's the main thing.
See, most of the transportation ambulances are geared towards adults.
Who is joining us very shortly, he is having his lunch, and he also will be presenting a patient perspective. So the next, in connection with what we have spoken. So with these few words, what happened today is that I will present an overview of the challenges. My colleague, Dr. Bittai, we will have a fair perspective, one of the very technology. So with this, I'm going to make a beginning and tell you about the challenges of pediatric heart care in India. So, because some of these are kill, they kill children. So we need, as a result, because this has not received attention, it has gone. So this has become an important cause globally, not just in India. But if you see the Indian situation, there are more children born in India than anywhere else. This is a map that expands the area of the country based on the total numbers. So total number of babies born in India is the maximum anywhere else in the world. You have a larger population than China, but the China birth rate is very low. India birth rate is higher. As a result, there are more babies born in India than anywhere else. If there are so many babies born in India, it is natural that there will be more babies born than the little heart.
Using a laser to burn a layer in the laser, in the resin, and making one burn after the other, it converts this into a physical object. Okay, so this is the basic thing about 3D printing. But why do we talk about it? What do we as doctors, what is the use of 3D printing? Because as doctors, we need to really understand the problem that we are trying to treat. For example, as cardiologists, when we have a very complex heart defect, how do we normally see the heart defect? We do CT scan, we do MRI, we do echocardiogram, X-ray. All this we see on the computer screen, a layer. But how it is inside the body, do we know? We don't know. Only when the surgeon doctor opens and sees, only then finally he knows what is the defect like. So that is the important thing about medicine, that the better our awareness about the internal structure, the better will be the planning of our treatment. So difficult to imagine. So now, medical image like a CT or an MRI, we convert it into a three-dimensional model on the computer, first of all.
And then after that, we actually use these instruments called the 3D printers to actually convert that into a physical object. So the previous thing was just an image on the computer. Now you have a copy of the heart in your hand. Now with this in your hand, the surgeon doctor is able to plan the surgery with much more clarity. Okay, so now world leader in 3D printing software. So Amrita and Materialize have become printing technology. This is very new. Very few centers in across the world are using this. The first time that we use this office heart model to the surgeon's team. Now they could actually guess how it has to be repaired, where should you put the cut, how to fix this whole problem. So that really operated. One very unique thing, I'm very proud to have Hari actually standing here with me. One very unique thing is that, but everywhere he's been told that his heart, because it is too complex, we cannot operate, because everything was upside down, topsy-turvy in his heart. What we call as a crisscross heart. And again, Paul's June is the model that is there in Sir's hand right now. So we were able to actually look inside, see where the hole is, and how to operate this child. And this is an exact copy of the patient's. So this should have been absolutely straight. This is a 3D print of the patient's spine. So this is a very difficult surgery. But now, the surgeon actually had the spine in their hand. They could plan exactly where to put the nail, where to put the screws, what they are going to straighten it. And when they went to the theater, they were completely prepared. Because it becomes shorter. You need less time, you have less chance of creating complications, you have less bleeding, and the post-operative recovery also becomes better.